I do know Laura.
Yes, I know Laura.
Of course I know Laura.
Of course, we all know Laura.
I do know Laura.
Yes, I do know Laura.
I do know Laura.
Yeah, I know Laura.
Everybody knows Laura.
Hi, my name is Laura Shanholzer.
Laura is the Sodexo worker who swipes me in when I go to Baker.
She's like the gatekeeper of Baker.
She swipes the cards and she asks us how our day is.
Whenever I go into Baker, and she swipes my card and she and I talk.
She interacts with students every day, swiping them into Baker.
But she does it with style.
She's here almost every single day, and when she's not here, everybody wants to know where she's at.
But I don't know much about her life. I would like to know more about her life. She seems like a very interesting person.
I do not know anything else about Laura's life.
I know nothing about her other than she has longer hair than I do.
I'm from New Jersey. I was born in New York City, but I'm originally from New Jersey. I have two brothers and one sister. My sister lives in Florida. My older brother lives in Colorado, and my baby brother lives in California.
Do you know if she's married or anything?
I think so.
I think she's married.
I'm not sure.
I'm pretty sure she mentioned it once.
My husband said to us, let's move, let's go to Pennsylvania. He had some friends who lived in Hollidaysburg. So, and I worked for Wegmans at the time in State College. So I said, all right, let's have an adventure. So we moved to Donation right outside of Huntington. I saw an ad in the paper and I answered it and I started upstairs in the grill at first for a year. And then the next year they transferred me downstairs to the cafeteria and I worked the hometown line. And then I got to be the cashier and that's my favorite.
I think she has kids. Does she? No?
I have no idea. I don't think I've ever heard her talk about kids.
I don't know.
No, no children. No, no children.
She's a friendly face. You're really happy to see her every time you go into Baker. It's like, you know, she just kind of makes your day. Like, oh great, it's Laura. One person in this world cares about how my day went.
I want them to feel at home. I want them to feel comfortable. You know, especially the underclassmen and the international students, because can you even imagine being so far from home? And even when we have our breaks, they can't go home. And with the languages too, you know. And I find that if you just give them a nice warm smile and you keep at it, I've noticed that they do. They'll open up just a little bit. It takes a little time, you know, but it does, I think it does help.
I interact with Laura like I'm seeing a friend that I've known for most of my life. And we don't hang out often, but every time we do, she makes me happy.
I was very sick at one point in my life. I had blood clots and pneumonia and just blew up and the blood clots went to my lungs. I ended up in the hospital for 3 weeks. It was very bad. I was 23. I think that's what made me change too, was you just go for it. Because you just don't know. The one thing people don't know about me is that I've traveled the world. I've been to Europe. I'd go skiing in Austria every year. Had an audience with the Pope. I went skiing in Italy when I was in college. And I've been to Tahiti and Hawaii and Bermuda a lot and the Caribbean. I've been in a volcano and all over the United States. And I've been to many places and met a lot of different people, and it gave me a good insight. I think that's what helps me with my job, is that I know there's diversity and everybody's different. There's a lot of difference and nationalities and races and colors and religions, and you have to embrace them all because we're all on this earth together.
She's just very generous and very sweet.
You just kind of unload your problems onto her and she makes you feel good about your life.
None of it is necessary, but it just makes us all feel really, really happy to see her.
I enjoy people. I love people.